Hey everyone, welcome back to another Figma tutorial. Prototyping in Figma is very powerful and easy to learn. While learning Figma, I studied a lot of videos, but none of them covered all the triggers and their practical uses. So in this video, I have tried to cover them all. Even the least used ones, like touchdown, touchup, mouse enter, mouse leave. Stick around till the end to check them out. Timestamps are added in the description so that you can easily skip or repeat specific topic. Let's jump right into it. Let's start with the basics. Prototype means a simulation of final product that is used for getting feedbacks and testing. The prototype consists of lots of these interactions connected together to show you a complete simulation. Interaction has three parts. First, object or interface, with which we interact. Second is trigger or actions. This initiates the interaction. And the third one is response, which is desired output. The starting point in Figma is to create a connection. The connection may begin using little dot icon or node. When you drag that node, a connection arrow appears. You can connect to any top level frame by dropping an arrow on that. Figma will create a connection between starting object and destination frame. Once the connection is added for the first time, a small play icon appears on the start frame. It's the starting point of the prototype. We can easily change it later by simply dragging that icon to a desired starting point. The next step is to select a trigger. We have lots of options to choose from. Let's select tap, which is most common in all of them. We'll check others later one by one. The last step is to choose the response. Click on blue arrow to modify the action and transition. By default, navigate to is selected. Open overlay does precisely as the name suggests. The swap works best with overlay. Figma swaps frames with these options, just like instance swapping. The rest of the options are also self-explanatory. Let's complete our interaction by choosing the animations. Here comes the animation or transitions part. Let's check differences one by one. Instant. As the name suggests, Figma simply opens a new screen without any animation, without any delay. Hit the present icon to preview. This is how it looks. Dissolve. In this animation, screen 1 fades out and simultaneously screen 2 fades in. Here, two more properties are available for tweaking. First is easing, which controls the speed of the animation. We will try different easing options later. Next is duration of transition, in milliseconds. 1 second is 1000 milliseconds. To help you understand these transitions, I'll keep it to 2 seconds, that is 2000 milliseconds. Preview to see this in action. Move in. In this animation, screen 2 moves in and screen 1 remains there. This is how it looks. Notice how B moves in and screen A doesn't move. You can select direction as required. Move out. In this animation, screen 1 moves out to reveal screen 2. This is how it looks. Notice how A moves out to reveal screen B. Push. In this animation, screen 2 literally pushes away screen 1. This is how it looks. Notice how screen B pushes screen A out of the screen. Slide in. It's very similar to move in and move out. In this animation, screen 2 slides in and screen 1 slides away very slowly. In move in, screen 1 doesn't move at all. Slide out. In this animation, screen 1 slides out to reveal screen 2. Screen 2 slides in slowly. A slides out of the way to reveal B from underneath. Last and super cool animation is Smart Animate. It analyzes layers, groups, or frames with the same name and animates the difference between color, position, size, and other properties. In the same example, layers A, B, and C are same on both the screens. Those will remain unchanged. This is how it will look. Figma will gradually change color and text. Let's add active tab indicator to make it clear. Duplicate it on screen 2 and place it behind tab 2. As this position is changed, Figma will animate that. Make sure that names of both the layers are exactly the same. Let me play it again. How cool is that? Now you have understood all the building blocks of prototype. Let's see practical examples one by one. Let's start with the time trigger. Time triggers are best when you don't have any interactive element on the screen or want to trigger an action after a specific duration. Remember, time trigger is active only when the top level frame is selected. Here's an example of a splash screen and loading screens. Select the splash screen and connect it with the next one. Select trigger as after delay. I'll set the delay as 2 seconds or 2000 milliseconds. And animation to smart animate. Figma will open the next screen after 2 seconds. Great. By the way, you can also add animated GIF using LOTI files. Stay tuned for more tutorials on this. Anyways, let's repeat this process to connect rest of the screens. And this is how it will look. Next one is overlay. Just connect the info icon with overlay frame. Choose action as open overlay and set position to manual. Select close when clicked outside. If needed, you can also add background overlay, which is useful for pop-ups. I'll skip it for now. I'll keep animation to instant. Preview this interaction. Works as expected. Let's try another example. Instead of placing keyboard on the screen, we can add it as an overlay, and we can use it on any screen. Connect screen 1 and 2 with instant transition. When user is on screen 2, we want keyboard to show up. We will use time trigger of 200 milliseconds and select keyboard as overlay. Choose position as bottom center. To make it realistic, select animation to move in with upward movement. Preview and this is how it will look. Let's try touchdown or long press interaction. This is a unique interaction that you might not find in most other videos. To create tap and hold interaction, select the notification card object and connect that to the next screen. In trigger, select touchdown. This is like tap and hold. Click on trigger after delay icon, which can determine the duration of a tap and hold interaction. Let's set it to 2000 milliseconds or 2 seconds. Animation set to smart animate is in 300 milliseconds. Preview to see if it works. If you tap and hold on this card for 2 seconds, it should trigger the interaction. It worked. Superb. Let's try a different variation. When we tap and hold on text, we get multiple options. we can simulate that. Select the text layer which you want to select. Connect it to overlay on the top. Set trigger as touchdown or mouse down. Duration 2 seconds. Set it as overlay and manually adjust the position and preview. This looks excellent, just like a native app. Next one on the list is drag or swipe. This trigger is fun to try. It works exceptionally well with Smart Animate. Check this first example of swipeable cards. I have given layer names and positions properly to make sure that Smart Animate works well. I have also reduced size of the cards, which will give subtle cover flow animation effect. Select the first active card and connect it to the next screen. Set trigger as drag. Animation as Smart Animate and duration to 300 milliseconds. Since the last update, you can now add two triggers on the same object. Connect card 2 to screen 1 and screen 3 by following the same steps. In the end, complete the steps for screen 3. Hit preview to see it in action. So smooth, you'll fall in love with Figma. Next drag example simulates a zoom slider. I'm using the same slider element on two screens with scaled images. Simply connect the slider pointer to the next screen and set up properties. Set Smart Animate duration as 2 seconds. Connect sliders 2 to screen 1 in similar way to complete the loop. Make sure that both sliders have fixed positions while scrolling. Preview to check it out. I can't believe we created this in just 4 layers. This is so awesome! The next one is swipe gesture in mail. To simulate this, just select the mail and connect it to the next screen. Select trigger as drag and transition to move out. Set duration as 1000 milliseconds. Also select Smart Animate checkbox. Connect the other screens to complete interaction. Preview it. This looks just like a real app. See how easy it is to create these interactions. The next examples are mouse interactions. To create a hover effect for navigation, I have created hover states of all the tabs on the top. Select tabs and connect to the hover style tab on the top. Select trigger as while hovering. Choose action as overlay and set position to manual. Place it exactly on top of the selected tab. Repeat this multiple times and connect other tabs and hit preview. The hover effect is working as expected. Next is while pressing state. To simulate that, create two states of the button. One is hover state and one with press state using inner shadows. First, connect button to hover state using while hovering trigger, overlay, and instant animation. Now select hover state and connect it to the press state. Now select trigger as while pressed and set action as swap. This will swap this frame with the press state till the mouse is pressed. Let's preview this interaction. This looks very realistic. horizontal and vertical scrolling is super easy. This uses simple frame properties. Simply select the outer frame and choose clip content. Go to Prototypes tab and select overflow behavior as horizontal scroll. Do a similar step for screen 2, but select both horizontal and vertical scroll at this time. Preview to see this in action. This is an effortless but very effective technique to create a prototype. Mouse enter and mouse exit. This is the coolest trick that I learned recently. Using this trigger, let's simulate fixed header behavior for the website where the header shrinks its size while scrolling. Setup is pretty simple. We have two versions of header on two pages and regular content sections. I have added a layer called mouse enter exit trigger. Select that layer and connect it to another screen. Select trigger as mouse enter. Select transition as instant and click on preserve scored position. This is very critical. Hit preview. As soon as mouse enters this trigger area, our page will change. But this will preserve the scroll location, making it seamless. On the second screen, we have to create the exact opposite. When mouse exits from this area, we want to bring our big header back. So now select trigger again and connect it to the first screen. Set trigger as mouse leave, instant and preserve scroll position. Also make these triggers transparent by reducing the opacity to 0. Hit preview. Now this sticky header expands and shrinks beautifully. Sometimes you need to trigger actions on keyboard input. One of my favorite survey tool called Typeform enables you to completely fill out the form using just a keyboard. We can now prototype that inside Figma. Select the option and connect that to the next screen. Select trigger as key and gamepad. Transition as instant. On second screen, select time trigger with smart animate to go to question number 2. Follow the same process till the end and hit preview. We can now interact with this prototype with just keyboard. I simply love this feature. That's all about prototyping. I hope you can now build fully interactive apps in Figma using techniques we practiced today. You can achieve lot of things here. You just have to be little creative. With this tutorial, Figma complete course is now complete. Hit like if this video was helpful. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay notified about the upcoming tutorials. Oh yes, I would love to hear from you about what you want to learn next. How about creating a new series for animations and micro interactions in Figma? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this till the end. I'll see you in the next one.